maybe a little bit to the right. Now left. Ugh. Can you even lean back? Now your legs are sticking out of the water. Move a little bit. Oh, but now your shoulders are. Not quite. It's not that comfortable for your neck. Ugh. You feel like a giant. Why is this bathtub so small? Well, it's not only to irritate you when you want to chill out after a long day at work, and it's not just you. Everyone's thinking the same thing. Well, here's the story. Bathtubs showed up more than 5,000 years ago as people discovered and developed the earliest plumbing system, probably in ancient India. They were a long way off from copper bathtubs or wooden barrels or our modern porcelain ones, but they still got the job done. Most European ones were made of tin, copper, or iron, and usually had that classic clawfoot-style design. A little later, someone thought to use porcelain instead of metal. It would be more comfortable and easier to clean and produce. It was expensive to have a huge tub, so the standard size in most homes was around 3 feet by 5 feet. That size wasn't just to make it cheaper, it had to do with safety. When you're in a bathtub, enjoying some relaxing me time, you might just close your eyes, fall asleep, or slip down in the tub a bit. Since tubs are a little shorter than the average person, your face isn't in danger of going under, your feet will hit the other end and stop you. Well, as life got more and more fast-paced, the idea of a huge, relaxing, hours-long bath pretty much went out the window. There's no time to relax when you work full-time, people. Sure, it would probably make us better workers, more relaxed and productive. Hey, I'm gonna mention it to my boss at the next company meeting. Yeah, I bet that'll go well. The other reason, it's just really, really hard to install a gigantic bathtub. It's got to get through the bathroom door, which is usually somewhere upstairs. It's not that easy to get a regular bathtub into the average city apartment. And plus, those big, fancy tubs, who can afford that? Standard bathtub size also depends on the culture. Europeans tend to prefer a slightly bigger tub than their American counterparts. Some have smaller but deeper tubs, kind of like the wooden barrels they used to use back in the day. Mystery solved, but other things still need answering. Let's see. How about those metal rivets all over your denim? They're not there because of some fashion trend. They're put in strategic places where jeans often used to fall apart. Jeans are something we all wear nowadays, but they were originally something mostly farmers, ranchers, and miners wore. So manufacturers needed to come up with a way to make jeans more durable. Okay, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 4 pockets. That makes sense. But that fifth tiny one? People usually store lip balm or one tiny coin in there. But originally, it was designed to store a pocket watch. And what? What is up with those tiny fabric squares you sometimes get when you buy new clothes? It's not like those extra buttons. Those actually come in handy. They were added so you could test your cleaning products. That way, you know if some detergent or other is going to ruin your brand new outfit. Smart. The beanie. Ah, what a classic. Adding that poofy pom-pom on the top may seem like nothing but fashion. Vikings used to wear beanies to keep their ears warm during really cold winters. The pom-pom was added to the top to keep the seams together and stop them from falling apart. That hole in the handle of every pan in the house? It's there so you can hang it up in your kitchen, right? No. The hole is there to hold your stirring spoon. Finally, a good place for it. It's been there all along. Not much use to me. I just do sandwiches 7 days a week. But it's good to know. All soda cans come with a tab so you can easily open your beverage. Everybody knows that. And that big hole in the tab is there to make it easier for you to put your finger under the tab to pop it open. Everyone knows that too. Wait, what? Oh, the hole's there to hold your straw in place. Genius. That plastic liner you see inside a soda bottle cap, it's not there just so you can see if you won a prize or something. That little liner's the hero in the soda saga. It helps you get a refreshing fizzy drink instead of flat syrup. It keeps the bubbles in the bottle. Cheers. Yeah, it's frustrating when you have to pick out rice or noodles from that takeout box. But if you unfold it, you can eat it off a plate. Not bad. Those holes you see on the side of your sneakers, they're there for ventilation and lacing. If you loop the shoestring through those holes, your sneakers won't rub against your heel. They'll fit better, and you won't get blisters. You've also probably wondered what these notebook margins are for. They weren't designed for your professor to fill with red pen marks, like mine did. People who design notebooks put in margins to protect your work. Rats used to be a common thing in many people's homes, and guess what their favorite snack was? Yup, your paper. Since a rat ate my homework probably didn't go over too well back then, manufacturers added wider margins so your work would stay safe. Flying high, finally heading to your long-awaited vacation. Hey, where did that little hole in the window come from? Termites? Well, it was there the whole time. The opening is there to allow a small amount of airflow. That reduces the pressure inside the plane as it climbs. It also keeps the windows from fogging up from the warm breath of all those gossipy passengers. Like that dude in the middle seat. Some coins have ridge patterns all around the sides. Back in the old days, coins were made of different types of metal, and their value was linked to their weight. For instance, 1 ounce of silver would be crafted into one silver dollar. Then some sly genius started shaving off the coin edges. They would do that to a bunch of coins, then they'd melt those shavings into a new coin. Well, to avoid that, coin minters came up with that clever anti-theft ridge pattern. Lollipops usually have tiny holes near the top of the stick. And nope, they're not there to be used as a whistle. Although that's fun to do, I must admit. The reason for the hole is so the candy doesn't slide off the stick. Manufacturers melt the candy and pour it into the mold while it's still hot. Some of that candy seeps into that small hole and creates a sort of candy hook. When you notice those blue bristles on your toothbrush are fading, it just means you need to replace it. So, now you know. Toothpaste sometimes comes in colorful stripes, and each color represents a different function, like whitening, fresh breath, and gum strengthening. But that doesn't mean your all-white toothpaste doesn't do the same thing. It does. It's just a trick one of the big toothpaste companies came up with. Ah, that new shoe smell. It's not just pure happiness, though. Sometimes it sure feels that way. It's a freshness that mostly comes from those small silica gel packets included in the box. Silica gel sucks the moisture out of its environment. That way, your shoes stay safe, nice, and dry. You know how everyone recommends you dump your phone in uncooked rice when it gets wet? Well, these packets do the same thing, only better. So don't throw them out, you might need them later, clumsy. Rings also have an interesting backstory. They haven't always been worn for fashion purposes. In the past, for those in nobility, a ring was a seal stamp, while archers used them to protect their thumbs from bowstring injuries. That has a nice ring to it.